skies smiling at me.
Nothing. Hey guys, now that everyone's gone, do I see? I'm gonna call some people.
Bluebirds singing a song. Nothing but blue skies from now on.
It'll be hilarious because people will be like, when was the show? I didn't know there was a show. Why don't you announce your shows? Why don't you tweet about them or write them on Facebook? And call them noobs and stuff.
All of them gone. Nothing but blue skies from now on.
So while Brent Westwood was on, I was collecting numbers for Twitter complainers. I thought that would be fun to do that. I haven't done those in a while. This is RBCP, by the way. It's a live show on July 20th. I guess it's the 21st, technically, but it's Saturday night. I doubt many of these are going to answer, but I can give it a try. Maybe if I get up early enough tomorrow, I can do a few in the morning. These people, you know, they're on Twitter and they like to complain a lot. So I just do searches for the keywords: horrible customer service, terrible customer service. And I find lots of people complaining about lots of companies, like this guy Robert. He's like, bye-bye Sprint, I switched to AT&T because of horrible customer service and cell service. Your loss, AT&T's gain. And then I searched for his number, and I found it. So I'm going to give him a call. Of course, nobody's going to answer this time.
I'm sorry, but the person you called has a voicemail box that has been set up yet. Goodbye.
Let's try again. His tweet is like, bye-bye. Being really snarky there, Robert. Shut up, Dirty Aaron. I even stole the music from the end of Dirty Aaron's show. I played some Skrillex while I decided if I was going to do this or not.
I'm sorry. The person you called, voicemail box, has not been yet. Goodbye.
Balls. Alright, let me note that he did not answer. I would have submitted these to you, Dirty Aaron, but like you didn't even call the number that Cool Rob gave you. He didn't call the number that I gave you. We submitted numbers. You don't want my dumb numbers anyway. Because these aren't going to answer, especially this late at night. This guy is in Michigan. And it's like 3 in the morning. It's 4 in the morning there right now. Wait. Yeah, 4 in the morning. This guy's name is Sammer. And, he doesn't plan on doing any more business with Amazon because they have horrible customer service, especially for a customer who's done so much business with them. Poor Sammer. Poor Sammer. Poor Sammer. Poor Sammer.
Hello?
Oh, hello. Could I speak with Sammer, please?
Who is this?
Oh, my name is Dave. I'm calling from Amazon. He had contacted us earlier. He's having some problems.
Are you serious? You're calling at 4 o'clock in the morning?
Oh, don't get an attitude with me. We're just trying to help.
4 o'clock in the morning?
Is this Sammer or is this... Are you Sammer?
You know, call back.
What? No, I will call back. We're trying to resolve your issues so you'll stop slandering us on Twitter.
He's got issues on Twitter, and you want me to wake him up at 4 o'clock in the morning?
Yes, he asked us to call. He said this was the best time to call. He checked the little checkbox on the website that said call us at this time.
And he gave you the house phone number. You know what? Just go to hell.
What? He I love when they hit touch tones when they try to hang up. Damn, Sammer.
Hi, you've reached 479.
Blah, blah, blah. No,
sorry,
no.
Sorry we couldn't get your call fast enough. But if you...
Well, that was fun. I got told to go to hell. It's always nice to hear right before you go to bed. Zipcar, New York City. I'm not sure exactly what Zipcar is. It's like some sort of car rental. Like you just leave them parked on the street and somebody else picks them up. It's kind of a cool service. Here's a tweet by Dinian. Just received terrible customer service from Zipcar, New York City. I've been a member since 2007 and I should not be treated this way. She lives in Jersey, but her phone number is in a different state, which is weird. She has her own domain name that's her full name. And that's how I found her. I just looked at the Whois info on her domain info. No, Ram, I'm not live right now. This is pre-recorded. Stop being dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Dumb, dumb, stupid. Stupid, dumb. Yeah, so if I happen to wake up at a good hour tomorrow, you know, early enough, I'm going to do them.
Hi, you've reached Denise, unfortunately.
Don't say your last name, God. Yeah, I might try and do a show in the morning to get through some of these numbers that we'll be more likely to answer in the daytime. All right, next one is Grant. Grant, you all screwed the pooch with your terrible customer service tonight via phone. Get real, Dish. And it's at Dish. I assume that's the Dish network. Television machine. Satellite machine. This one, like, I think I may have gotten the wrong guy on his phone number. But it's a city like 30 miles away from where he's supposed to be. And it's a sort of unique name.
Hello.
Hi, is this Grant?
This is Grant.
Oh, hi, this is David from Dish Network. I understand you're having some problems with our customer service earlier.
Oh, I don't know.
Do you have Dish Network?
Dish Network.
You know, for your television machine?
Yeah.
Oh, were you having issues with the customer service?
Don't think so.
Did you contact us recently?
I could ask my wife. Sandra, did you contact with Comcast?
Yeah, the district.
Yeah, district.
District.
This is David. I think you've been out to our home, right?
Yeah, well, not me personally. I'm just calling from the customer service.
Oh, I
was just trying to resolve your issues.
Oh, I didn't know we had any, really. Oh. Unless my son called.
Is your son's name Grant?
No, that's me.
Oh, okay. No,
His name is David.
Oh.
The only thing we had is the cable's getting a little low outside, and it was fluttering.
Oh, fluttering. You don't want your cables to flutter. Uh-uh. Nope.
No, you know what I'm saying is the TV flutters. And
The TV flutters. That's even worse.
Well, that's because it's out there on the telephone pole.
You shouldn't have the TV on the telephone pole outdoors. TVs are not made to be outdoors.
Right.
There's like those little ventilation things on top. The water could leak in.
Right.
And we just had a storm recently, and that could ruin your TV if you get water in it.
Yeah, well, the TVs aren't outside. It's the cable is.
Oh.
Okay. It's the only issue we've had is that your TV will flutter inside the house.
Oh.
The screen goes up and down, but that's just like you said, it could be from... something, you know, water. Yeah. Kind of crazy. Why would you be calling at 3:00 in the morning?
Oh, don't get smart with me. I'm just trying to figure out the customer service issue.
I see.
Do you use Twitter? Like, we've had some issues with Twitter interference. Oh, you're the wrong Grant, then. I have a quick fix for the fluttering issue.
Sure.
Sandra's there next to you.
Yep.
If you could ball your hand up into a fist and punch her in the face.
That would take care of it, huh?
Yeah, that would fix everything.
Oh. Well, now I know why you're calling at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Why? Because I'm a prank caller?
No.
Oh, why?
you're not with the company at all.
Oh. No, that's all not right? true. I really am with Dish.
So, you're with what?
No, I really am with Dish Network.
Oh, you're with Dish Network.
Yeah. What do you think I meant?
Oh, well, we don't have Dish.
But okay. I asked you if you had Dish, and you said yes.
Yeah, no.
But then you're talking about cables on the telephone pole. We don't put our dishes on the telephone pole. Don't be stupid.
No, I think I'm talking to somebody who's kind of stupid. If you're with Dish, we're not interested in talking to you. Okay.
Well, no, I'm just trying to see if you want to switch over to our services, because we're better than cable. This is a marketing call.
I see. Well, I'll tell you what, I'll talk to you some other time when it's worth talking to you, okay?
Look, you won't have fluttering issues with Dish like you do with cable.
Yeah. You sound like somebody who can't sleep at night. And this is kind of a random call, right?
No, it's not random. We targeted you directly. You're on our list of people to call.
I'll be darned.
Yeah, I mean, we're just trying to, you know, I work on the night shift. It's not that I can't sleep. It's just that I work nights. I'll be sleeping, you know, tomorrow during the day.
Okay. Well, anyway, I do sleep nights, and I'm going to go back to sleep.
Well, I mean, have you considered how much cheaper we are than your local cable service?
No. You're not. In fact, everybody I know who has Dish can't stand them.
Oh, they're all full of shit.
I know.
You don't need to...
I know. Anyway, good night.
They don't know what they're talking about. I work for Dish, and they don't. So if you want to know... And he's gone. Yep, that was that was the wrong Grant. But that was still fun. I swear, I asked him if he's with Dish, and he said yes at the beginning, didn't he? I thought he did. WTF Grant. Grant and Sandra. And their son Dave. Yes, I can delete that one. Since there's no chance of him tweeting about anything, since it's the wrong guy. This is another one where I'm kind of questioning if I got the right person or not. Her name's not, you know, too unique. But it's close to the city she's in. Delta, going on 28 hours and still can't locate my luggage. You still can't locate my luggage. I filed a claim after 5 days is what I'm told. After 5 days is what I'm told? Hey Delta, thanks for losing my luggage and having terrible customer service. So that's what Amber says. And I'm really doubting I have the right Amber here on this phone number. But I'm going to give it a try. She's also in the Midwest. This is going to be a very short show, by the way. I'm just, I just want to go through this list.
Hello.
Hi, Amber.
What?
Is this Amber?
There is nobody by the name of Amber here.
Well, she gave this number. You don't need to be smart with me. I'm calling from Delta. She had her luggage lost. Okay, let me try again. I think that was Amber lying to me.
Hello?
Amber, we got disconnected somehow. Listen, we found your luggage. So everything's going to be...
There is nobody by the name of Amber here.
I recognize your voice. I talked to you at the Delta counter.
You're fucking high, dude.
I'm not. All right. Hey. Amber. Amber, why do you keep picking up like that? Are you trying to star 5-7 me? Amber. 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 Okay, now she's gone for real. She kept picking up on her phone, and it wasn't hanging up. Like she's trying to pick up for some reason. Okay, next one. I'm halfway down the list. This is what I did during the Dirty Aaron show tonight. I looked up Twitter complainers and got their info. And now I'm calling them. These are by Cindy Hagman. Smokies Baseball, your ticket manager refused our AAA discount worth $10. Claimed they couldn't do it because they already charged the credit card. Hashtag rude, hashtag AAA. Then there's another tweet, 2 hours after that tweet. Smokies Baseball, I don't believe you. Nothing you can do, like void the transaction or give us a $10 cash? A third tweet. Smokies Baseball, we left and will never go back. Hashtag bad customer service, hashtag rude, hashtag stealing money. And apparently there was a conversation between these people. Let me see if I can access that. View conversation. Oh, yeah, it just says, unfortunately, once your credit card has been ran, there is nothing we can do. And yes, they said, once your credit card has been ran, there is nothing we can do. But they all live in Tennessee, so they're allowed to have that kind of grammar. So the Smokies Baseball thing is a baseball field of some sort. It kind of looks like a, you know, like a little community baseball thing, but it's a little bit bigger than that. There was quite a crowd from what I could see in the picture. So let's see if I got the right Cindy. Oh, no, I got the right person. I'm sure of that because her name is weird enough that...
Hello?
Oh, hi, is this Cindy?
Yeah.
Hi, this is Craig from Smokies Park. I understand you're having some problem with your credit card and discount.
You're calling me at 4:30 in the morning?
Well, yeah, I'm just trying to get this resolved. It looks like...
At 4:30 in the morning? Are you kidding me?
No, of course not. It's not. It's 4:24, so don't exaggerate. I was just going to see if I could go ahead and get this charged for you, this $10 discount. But yeah. It looks like we accidentally ran your credit card twice, so it charged the full amount twice. So we're actually going to need to refund one of the charges, but while we're doing that refund, if it works, assuming it works, then we can go ahead and take an extra $10 out with that.
Can you call me back in an hour that's decent?
What's wrong with this hour?
4:30 in the morning?
No, I'm just trying to help you.
I mean, I'm sorry, but 4:30 in the morning?
Well, it's not quite 4:30. It's more like 4:25.
Oh, well, excuse me. It's 4:25.
The credit card in here. It looks like... Oh, yeah. I just charged it a third time. Now it's gone through three times. I'm sorry, ma'am. So we've charged your credit card for the full amount three times. So I'm going to do a refund twice.
You don't even know it's not my credit card, it's my husband's credit card.
Well, yeah, but I mean you're the one we talked to. I mean that's the name that's on it. It says Cindy on here. Did you sign it when you were here at the park?
It's 4:31.
Hello, Cindy.
Who's this?
Hi, this is Dave from the Smokies Park.
Uh-huh.
I was just trying to figure out the credit card thing here. It looks like we accidentally charged the credit card for the full amount three different times.
Uh-huh.
And I'm trying to do the refund, but it's not going through. We're having computer problems here.
Okay.
But I don't think I'm going to be able to do the discount then, because I was hoping to give a discount as I did the refund, but I can't do the refund at all, so... It actually looks like you've paid three times as much at this point.
Oh, that's good.
So I'm really sorry about that.
Okay, so what are you going to do to fix it?
I don't know. She already told us she wasn't going to come back ever again, so I guess, I mean, we'll just apologize and...
Well,
sorry about that.
Yeah. What's your name?
My name's Dave Still.
Dave Still?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
At the Smokies Park.
Yeah. Okay. So
I'll keep trying, though. I'll keep trying to do this refund, but it doesn't seem like it's going to work because our computer is old and broken.
Okay. All right. So, listen, just stop whatever you're doing.
I'm trying to run it again.
Yeah, don't try and run it again.
I'm just afraid if I do it again, it's going to run it a fourth time and charge your credit card.
Yeah, but don't do it right now.
Amount.
So when
fourth time. Oh, it just went through.
Talk to the general manager tomorrow. It's
going through
the whole thing refunded. Okay.
I think it's. Well, I'm not sure if I just did a refund or if it just charged it again.
Okay. Well, let's just stop.
Okay. Can you tell your wife I'm sorry I called so late, but you know she didn't have to have that kind of attitude with me. I mean, she was freaking out at me, and I didn't appreciate that at all.
Okay.
I'm writing a report here that says, had attitude, kept telling me what time it was.
All right. Okay.
Okay.
David Still. All right.
Yeah, David Still.
And can you give me the number again so that when I'm awake, I'll call back?
Oh, the telephone number?
Yep.
Area code 865.
Okay. All right. Okay.
I'm trying to slide the card. I mean, type the card through again. It just doesn't seem to be working.
Okay. Let's just stop what you're doing.
Uh huh.
Okay. And
oh, there it goes. It just went through.
Okay.
Oh, but that was. I charged it again.
That's right. So
I'm
just
sorry.
Stop.
I've been drinking.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Just don't do it anymore.
Have a nice night.
We'll sort it out tomorrow.
Can I talk to Cindy? Maybe I could make things right with her.
No, we'll just stop right there.
I mean, like, I maybe she could help me run this credit card through again.
No, just stop. Okay.
I'll try to stop.
Okay.
Okay. Well, have a nice night.
Bye.
Have good dreams.
Bye.
Goodbye. Goodbye, John.
Bye.
I can't wait tomorrow to see the tweets that happened from that one. I need to make some notes here real quick. Yeah, the end. Dick Soup is lying. I'm not really live on the cacti stream. You know why? Because there is no cacti stream. I killed the cacti stream. It's gone. It doesn't exist anymore. Stupid Dick Soup. What does he know? Dur. I want to play a song. I want to take a break. Not for any reason at all. I just want to take a break and play a song. All right. I'll be right back, you guys. One song. I'm going to look through my list, get organized here, and I will be right back.
Trocadero in Philly, backstage at the Bloodhound show. She said she was from Cherry Hill, threw lips like cherries in the snow. New Jersey girl, come on and rock my world. New Jersey girl, she didn't talk to Charlie, our old bass player. And she didn't go off with Steve. Not the cougar. Yeah, she took me up to the balcony, past Kenneth Keith Kallenbach, and gave a yingling to me.
Ow!
New Jersey girl, come on and rock my world, New Jersey.
I hate bad customer service. I hate when people blatantly lie to me. Toyota, you're on my list now. You're on my list. That's from Chelsea. Hello? Hello, is Chelsea there?
She is.
Is this Chelsea?
She's asleep in the other room.
Oh, is this Emily?
That's like a message.
Is this Emily?
Uh-huh.
Oh, she asked me to give her a call. I'm calling from Toyota.
In the middle of the night?
Yeah, she said this would be the best time to call.
Sorry, we just did our relative house.
Oh.
I'll tell you what.
No, I tell you what. You go wake her up. This is really important. She asked me to call. It's really, really important.
Okay.
Oh, it's so important.
Yeah, it's very important.
Yes. Could you go wake up Chelsea for me?
I'm going.
Okay. Oh, thank God.
Hey, Chelsea. I'm sorry. There's somebody from Toyota on the phone for you. You told them to call at this time. Oh, good.
Hello?
Chelsea?
Yes.
Well, I'm calling from the corporate office over here at Toyota.
Yeah.
And we heard that that we're on your list. You put us on your list.
Yes.
You think you can just put us on a list like that? I mean, we're a major multi-billion national corporation. We have dot matrix printers here. Can't put us on a list. What did we do that was so horrible that you put us on a list?
I'm sorry. What do you mean?
Well, you say we're on your list. What kind of list are we on? Is that a threat? Are you threatening us? Are you threatening a corporation? I mean, we have a lot of lawyers. Oh. I'll have you know.
No, I'm not threatening a corporation.
Okay, well, that's good. Because we don't want that. We don't want threats.
I got shitty customer service, and I got, that's what it was.
Go ahead.
What is this?
What'd they do with customer service that was so bad?
They lied to me.
How'd they lie?
Credit.
They what? What about credit?
I don't know who this is, but it's 3 o'clock in the morning.
Well, I'm Paul from Toyota. How'd they lie? What about credit?
I don't think this is someone with Toyota.
Why would I say I'm from Toyota when I'm not? I mean, we know you had problems. I just wanted to make sure we're not on your list.
I just told you it was what kind of list it was.
What kind of list is it?
When I told you what it was, the list.
What list? What kind of list is this? Who else is on the list?
Places like Wendy's. And I don't believe this is Toyota.
Wendy's?
If this is someone from Toyota, you can call my cell phone, not my mom's cell phone, at 3 in the morning.
Oh, well, you didn't give us your cell phone number. Should I try and call
that's
one then?
Crap.
What's crap?
What?
This is the cell phone number you put on here.
No, it's not.
It is. Why would I call this number?
I have no idea. I don't know how you got this number, honestly.
I'm gonna call Dave over at Wendy's and find out, like, if you've been threatening them too and putting them on lists.
I don't know who this is, but please don't call again, because you're full of shit.
I'm not full of shit. I can't believe you'd use that kind of language with a multi-billion national corporation. Listen. Before you hang up. Aww. She hung up. Oh, well. I don't know why, but the stream went out again. Not the phone loser stream, but the the other stream, the Madhouse stream. And it does that when I get too quiet, but I don't think I was quiet, was I? I guess I'll have to listen to the recording tomorrow and see if I got quiet when that happened. That was fun. Okay, let me do some typing here. There are two people left. Stephanie says, United Airlines has a complete lack of compassion and makes me rethink my 10 years of loyalty. It's time to consider other options. Poor Stephanie. Hello? Hello, Stephanie? Aw. Stephanie? Whoa, whoa, what's going on here? I did not dial back. Something's...
Hello?
Oh, hi, is this Stephanie?
Yes.
Oh, hey, this is Roy from United. I understand.
Oh.
You're having some issues?
Yes, I did.
Oh, what was that? What happened exactly?
Oh, okay. I thought you said, hold on a second.
Oh, no.
Very strange that you're calling me. Sorry, I was asleep.
Oh, okay.
Do you have my flight information?
Yeah, we have that here.
Okay, hold on 1 minute.
Okay. Type in the flight information. Just gotta get a print out of this. Are you still there, ma'am? Stephanie?
Stephanie. Okay, you know, it's actually, I just checked the clock. It's 1:45 in the morning. I'm going to go ahead and finish with my letter, and then I'll talk to someone another time.
Well, exactly what happened, though?
This is not the time for the story. I will finish my letter and talk to someone another time. Mm-hmm. I have a hard time believing customer service would call me at 1:45. So,
well, I don't know.
Thank you.
It sounds
and,
like you have an attitude. I mean, I can understand why they give you problems. And she's gone. One left. One person left. Darn it. All right, let me make a note on this one. Whitepages.com is coming in really handy for these things. That's helped me get a lot of info tonight. Really terrible customer service from Virgin America. I thought they were better than this. So this is Victoria. She lives in Virginia. It's 4:45 in the morning over there. So maybe she's up already for the day. Going to work. Yes, Tyler. It's live.
Hello?
Oh, hi. Could I talk to Victoria? I'm calling from Virgin America. There's a
What's in regard to?
Oh, it's just it's between me and Victoria. She had some problems with her flight.
Hold on a second.
Okay.
Hello?
Hey, Victoria.
Yeah?
Oh, it's Roy from Virgin America.
Yeah.
I understand you're having some problems. What kind of problems were you having earlier?
No, I don't have any problems. It's 4:45 in the morning.
Well, it said there was, like, an issue with customer service?
Not me. Maybe it was my son was flying along from coast to coast.
Oh, it was Aaron. He's the name on here. Is he there? Is he around?
Oh, this isn't his number. And I don't think you should call at 4:45 in the morning.
Oh, well, I mean, you don't understand how we do things. So, I mean, don't throw your opinions at me like that. So he lives at a different place? Do you have a number for him?
I do, but I don't think you should call him at 4:45 in the morning.
Oh, don't. He's not a pussy like you. Come on, just give me the number. Ah, I was actually clearing my throat to keep the stream alive. Oh, were they still there? Hello? Hello? Crazy home phones and the crazy things they do. I'm still connected, it says. Oh well, if I wake up early enough in the morning, I will definitely try and call these ones that didn't answer tomorrow morning. I don't know what time that'll be. I guess, you know, like 7 or 8 hours from right now. 10 Pacific. 9 or 10. Hopefully I'll get up by 9. I want to sleep all day. Shut up, Tyler. Shut up, the inn. I don't need your bullshit here. Aaron show tonight was... He kept doing that hilarious thing where he's like, ugh, gross, yuck, gross. We need sound clips of that. I want to do Dirty Aaron's and Cobra's sounds of disgust. I want those on my soundboard. That'll be hilarious. Hilarious. Also, last night, on last night's JIAD show, whatever the fuck he's calling it now, he did something epic. He got a guy, a drunk guy, to punch another drunk guy in the face. And it caused some sort of, like, little miniature riot last night. It was pretty amazing. If you missed the phone larking show last night, you should figure out where that's put up, you know, archived, and listen to it for the July 19th show. Listen to July 19th, The Art of Phone Larking. It's fucking hilarious. A guy gets punched in the face. Because JIAD tells him to, and people are stupid. Stupid! It's amazing. Ah, Dick Soup has a great idea. He says... Dick Soup has the most amazing idea ever, and I'm gonna do it right now. Hold on 1 second. I just happen to have that phone number here, Dick Soup. Dick Soup says I need to call KDK and ask him to do prank calls with me. Hey, Tyler says the JIAD call reminds him of PrankNet. I think I need to go to phonelosers.org/rules. And
your call has been...
And kind of rewrite those and include the rule that says you really shouldn't, you know, make people, you know, assault each other. I think I need to add assault. I always said personal property damage was something you shouldn't do. No, actually, I hope every prank caller listening to this does make people assault each other.
Hello?
That was amazing. Hi, Dave. It's Roy. You want to do prank calls with me? I want to call a restaurant. You hung up. KDK just answered. I don't think he liked the music.
Your call has been forwarded to an...
KDK is very specific about the things he will and will not do. He will not call restaurants. You will never find KDK making a prank call to a restaurant.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated...
Oh, he shut it off. I'm going to leave him a message.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging.
There were more rings that time, so... I'll try again, because you know he's just hitting that button in frustration. He's not happy about being called right now.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Dave Caron.
Is not available. At the tone, please record your message. When you've finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options. To leave a callback number, press 5.
Hey, Dave. I'm calling from the prank calling show. I really wanted you to make some prank calls with me to restaurants and stuff. It was going to be really funny. I mean, you're a prank calling legend. And we really need you on our show to just bring in the, you know, hundreds and thousands of listeners. Because we want you to be on our show so we can get more listeners that way. Because everybody knows who KDK is. And if everyone knows KDK is on our show, that'll make our shows popular. And it'll be so awesome. So please, please stop hitting the button. Pick up your phone. You gotta make a prank call to me. I'll PayPal you $5. $5 for a prank call. It won't take more than like 5 minutes tops. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Please, Dave. Please. Please, please, please. Please prank call with me. Alright, thank you. Thank you for your considering it, okay? Goodbye. Alright, thanks for that dick soup. That was fun. I like that he picked up once and then just hung up immediately. Dirty Aaron also called him about an hour ago during his show, and he actually talked to Dirty Aaron for a while, but he acted like he was super important. He's just a god in the prank calling world. Anyway, yeah, I think it's time to go. I want to play a song. And after that song, the stream is going to drop, and I'm not going to come back. So thanks for listening, everyone. Bye. Hopefully I'll be back in about 6 to 8 hours. Everyone. Excuse me. It's the first time I've spoken this morning. My throat's all scratchy. I left my windows open so the stupid birds would wake me up this morning. And they did. I've gotten 6 hours of sleep. So this is going to be a short show. I just want to call these people back that I called last night. Or call the ones that didn't answer, I guess. There's these few things here that I keep forgetting to mention on the shows, because I haven't done a morning show in over a week now, but I have these notes here, and this guy Ace from the chat room is making these weird pendant things with phone loser art on them, and I've been wanting to mention this because I want to post a link to it in the show notes. So when you hear this show on the podcast feed, go look at phonelosers.org latest post, and you will see pictures of these pendant things. It's some kind of metal stuff that has PLA art, and he's selling them. It's amazing. I mean, they look neat. Yes, Sloth, I did calls last night. You missed it. I didn't want you to listen, so I didn't announce the show. It was very short, but some of the calls were sort of humorous, I thought. And I'm going to call some of them back today and call the ones that didn't answer. Because, I mean, it was 4:30 in the morning, as that one lady kept telling me. Also in my notes, Cacti Radio Facebook is now the Live Prank Show Network Facebook. And you can get to it by going to facebook.com/Live Prank Show Network. And I've updated the Shoutcast stream with new shows. So like when you listen to Phone Losers Shoutcast on the phonelosers.org, there's new stuff on it now instead of old phone shows and old PLA radios. There's like the new Snowplow show things. And I've been updating it every week with the new shows that come out. So yay! It's not just a bunch of old stuff. Alright, fuck updates. Let's go to the first one. Oh, I've been clicking on these people's Twitters from last night, and nobody's made any hilarious updates about my calls. So that's kind of depressing. This first one, it's Samer is the name, and he complained about Amazon. Said they have horrible customer service, especially for a customer who's done so much business with them. And I guess I talked to his wife and she told me to go to hell. That's what the notes here say. Hi, the inn. The inn's happy that I'm live. Sloth hates that I'm live. Fuck you, Sloth.
Hello?
Hi, can I talk to Samer this time? Or are you just going to tell me to go to hell? Can I please just talk to him? I'm calling from Amazon.
Just, let me see. Hold on a second.
Just put him on the phone. Come on. Quit being a bitch.
Hey, Thomas. It's that loser that calls off at 4 o'clock in the morning.
On the phone right now?
Yes.
Hello?
Oh, hey, Samer. I'm calling from Amazon. I understand you're having some problems with your order.
Yeah.
What kind of problems were you having?
Hold on. Can you go inside? What's that?
I asked, what kind of problems were you having?
Yeah, I had a rental that we didn't return, but I was never emailed for them. Or I was emailed, but all the emails went to my spam folder.
Uh-huh.
And so when I woke up and I checked my bank account, there was a $110 charge from Amazon. So when I checked it, it was saying for an overdue rental, which, of course, you know, I'd forgotten about since it had been a few months, but
oh, okay.
I didn't have any. All the emails went to my spam folder, so.
Oh, okay. Well, sounds like it's completely your fault then. You should learn how to manage your email account so you don't, you know, those don't go to the spam folder. I mean, stupid you.
Is this Amazon, you know?
Yes, yes.
Are you a representative from Amazon?
Yes, my name is Roy Gerbel.
Okay. And is there any reason for you to be rude about it?
No, I'm not being rude. It's just, I mean, it seemed like you were saying we did something wrong, but it sounds like we did everything right.
You did do something wrong.
Oh, what do we
do? There's no reason for you to have charged me for that.
Well, yeah, I mean, you should have got the emails saying that we were going to charge you. And, you know,
well, I didn't, so, I mean.
You probably used to rent from Blockbuster and blamed them when you didn't bring your movies back. And
are you being serious right now?
I'm just assuming that's probably what you used to do back when you did Blockbuster.
Are you being, like, actually serious right now?
Why do you keep asking me that? That's a stupid question.
This is not, there's no way this is Amazon.
Who else would I be calling you?
Probably Alan. Is this a recorded message?
Yes, I'm a recording.
No,
You figured it out. I'm a recording.
Excuse me?
I'm not going to respond to that because I'm a recorded message.
This is not Amazon. This guy sounds like a fucking queer.
Yeah. Let me see. Who is that?
Is it?
Remember
when you
called
back?
Yeah.
What kind of a company?
What?
What kind of a company was it?
Tree cutting service?
Is that?
That sounds like a
well, we don't have
a. There's
no way this is. Yeah, we don't have any trees for you to cut down.
Okay, that makes sense. Okay then, I'm glad I could resolve everything for you. Have a nice day.
Did you hear this?
Bye.
Probably read this from. Or movies from Blockbuster and blame them when they didn't when you didn't return them.
What are you supposed to return?
This guy's a fucking. I don't know who this guy is.
Then you're recording.
This guy needs to get fired.
It's not Amazon, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, tell them that you're recording it manually.
I love how upset you guys are. It's hilarious.
What's that?
I didn't say anything.
What is this?
Well, I mean, why are we on the phone with this guy?
Yeah, why don't you hang up on me, retards?
Oh, my God!
Hey,
you
hey.
Keep talking wait. Because we're recording you this time.
And they're gone. That was an odd call. Wow, I really upset their household. I wish they would tweet about me, though. Hopefully, by the time I post the show, they tweet something hilarious. This lady didn't answer last night. She's complaining about Zipcars. She's been a member since 2007 and should not be treated this way. It was terrible customer service. Terrible. Hello. Hi, is this Diane? Dinian, I'm sorry?
Mm-hmm.
Hello?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Oh, okay. You sound really... I'm calling from Zipcar. My name's Roy.
Hi, Roy.
Hi. Were you having problems with our service? It seems like we show that you're having problems here.
Yeah, I was having a really hard time, actually. A lot. So... I had rented a car, and when I went to pick it up, it wasn't at the location.
Uh-huh.
And so I called obviously the one of the agents, and the first agent that I spoke to, you know, she was just like, yeah, I don't know what to tell you. I was like, what? And it was a pretty high-pressure situation because I was actually on my way to work. And it was, you know, like 7 in the morning or whatever. And so I was like, well, I need to speak to a supervisor. So I spoke to a gentleman, and he was helpful. He he said that there was a cargo van available in my area. And so I drove. So at that point, I had already left the location where I was to pick up my car. And I went, and I was just going to go and try to get public transportation. And he called and said, well, we can put you in the cargo van that's close to you. So I said, okay, that's great. So I got the cargo van, went to work. On my way to work, I noticed that the cargo van, I mean, was having, like, some tire pressure issues. Like, there was, like, an alert on the dashboard.
Yeah.
And so I was like, okay, well, I'll worry about that when I get off work. So I called when I got off work, and I said, you know, this van is huge. I don't really feel comfortable driving it, and it's having tire pressure issues. You know, and they had told me previously that the car that was parked at the location where I was supposed to get my original rental, they told me that it was unavailable. But then they said that it's not scheduled to be rented, but that it had a maintenance ticket on it, and that it had like a pet smell. I said, well, I don't care about that. I said, I just can't drive this cargo van for the rest of my rental. Now,
listen, how many cigarettes do you smoke a day? Badfish wants to know how many cigarettes you smoke a day, because your voice sounds really scratchy.
Oh, I don't smoke at all.
Is it you?
I went to the Justin Timberlake concert last night.
Oh, I see. Yeah, okay.
No, I don't smoke at all, actually.
I see. Okay. Well, Badfish wanted to know. Well, it sounds like you just complain. It sounds like you just complain a lot. Maybe you should stick to public transportation. It's cheaper anyway, right?
I'm sorry?
I said it sounds like you just complain a whole lot, and maybe you should stick to public transportation.
Oh, I'm sorry that you feel that way, Roy. Actually, your colleagues would disagree because they actually refunded me the cost of both of my rentals.
Okay.
So I thought you were calling to actually be helpful. If you're not, you go fuck yourself.
Oh,
okay?
Listen to you.
You or anybody.
I don't think we want your business if you're going to talk to us like that. We got disconnected somehow. How'd that happen? I bet you she will tweet.
Hi, you've reached Denise. Unfortunately, I'm not able to take your call, but if you leave me a detailed message, I'll give you a call back.
Oh, hi, Denise. I'm typing up a report here in the computer under your name and saying that you're banned from ever renting a Zipcar again. So, pretty much just, like, don't try to rent from us anymore. Because we don't want your business. I'm printing out the report and hanging it on the wall so we don't forget. Okay, well, thank you for hanging up on the phone and cursing at me and everything. Goodbye. All right. I'm pretty sure she will tweet something. She seems to tweet a lot. She tweeted 2 hours ago. She tweeted, "Good morning." Shut up, Sloth. You don't know anything. All right, let me mark her as finished. The next one, I don't know if I want to call back, because last night we had a very long conversation about the baseball stadium. I kept saying I kept running her credit card over and over, and I kept double-charging her and triple-charging her. And I really thought they would tweet something, but they haven't tweeted anything in 15 hours. I should probably just let that one go. Breaking news, everyone. I'm told by VN and Sloth that Michelle has been tweeting nonstop for the past 30 minutes. So I'm going to go to her Twitter account, which I have bookmarked because I can't follow her because she's banned me from following her. All right, here it is. And it looks like there are angry tweets. So here's the latest tweets from Michelle. I should just read everything. "I hope those ranting tweets stop my bad dreams I had the other night. Oh, the bitchy cunt who whores think going to some school or religious place makes them the same thing as me. What dumb bitches believe that guy? Yuck. I said yuck to that motherfucker. Yuck. Yuck." That's the Dirty Aaron version of her tweet. "He better fuck off my Twitter profile and stop cause me bad dreams, asshole. Little cunts go to hell. They're the spiritual solution to answer those bitchy cunt whores anonymous fucking nasty prayers to bring hell and hate all around for their sake." This sounds like it should be a church sermon. "Expected me to be silent or polite about stuff like that? No way! I hope those tweets get rid of my bad dream I had. Are wasting my time. Are one of their stupid fucker guys did hate for their psycho whorish cunt brains again. Hear the new spiritual solution then to them. No whorish cunt bitches. No whorish cunt bitches. I am not for losers to pick on. Go pray spiritual, you fucking whores of hell anonymously. Idiotic cunts. Yuck. Yuck. Okay, cunt whores. Okay, cunt whores of hell. Idiotic bitches. Hear your stupid fucking spiritual solution and new thing for your hate-doing psycho-idiot guy also. These are perfect for a Sunday morning." That was 10 minutes ago. "Yeah, to those fucky cunt brain idiot females, I'm now tuned into hell and sex and sick shit. Just for your dumb precious asses." If any of you listeners out there are a songwriter, I would like you to do this. Please go to twitter.com/Michelle. It's M1CHILLE. And write a song. And the lyrics will be Michelle's tweets. Please do that. That'll be the coolest thing ever. Alright, where was I? "I am not the girl of the guy who stole my photo and made some fucking lame video either. Stupid fucking whores are glad he did that. Go hell." She's like cheering on hell. It's like, go hell. And she's referring to, I think it was Brent Westwood who made the fake Twitter profile of Michelle. "Some guy is making sick shit happen for real then. How I stop him, huh? Oh, I am not going to stop use my own name and profile because some pranking fake profile harassing on me. How I get that guy to just F off." Wow, Brent Westwood. That was like a week or two ago. You haven't touched your fake profile. I think maybe he took it down, but she's still talking about it. You really should leave this girl alone. Just leave her alone. Leave Michelle alone. I will always be using my own name photo at this Twitter profile here. Bring it, motherfucker losers. Harass me again here. I dare you. They all, we just dumb little whores for anything goes, anything at all. Theft, harassment, violence, because they stupid fucking whores. Oh, here's some more whorish bitches. I think I am the guy stole my photo and harassed me. Okay, dumb cunts of hell. Here more tweet for your asses. No to the faggot ass. I will always be using this Twitter profile of myself. Get a clue. Yet to that harassing psycho idiot guy. Just because looks easy to steal my photo and mimic, mock, make fake profile of me, you are not ever supposed to do that. Ever. Is wrong. For those who don't know who Michelle is, she's not responding to anybody. She's just talking to herself on Twitter. And nobody, I mean, rarely people reply to her. It's just weird. And these just go on and on. That tweet for those fucking candle cooing cunt, dumbest women whores then, enjoying this fucking mimic me anonymously too then, not. Oh, songwriters, that's gonna be the title of your song, Candle Cooing Cunts. Or some variation of that. That's the title of your song. I want this song made. ASAP, somebody make a song of tweets by Michelle, and then we can make a video or something using her pictures and send it to her, and it'll be hilarious. But leave her alone. Let's not bother her. Even though I want to do that. No to some fucker idiot dude. I'm not for harass. Mimic me. Steal my photos of me. You goddamn sick fucking asshole of a man. Yuck. Okay, cunty whores anonymous and their idiot afraid to talk about sex or anything. Now fuck off to hell for let that guy do all that to me. I cannot even enjoy my own body. Why not? The same to those dumb fucking candle cooing cunts then, and the vicious guy reading this. Now the cunt whores are justifying some guy make fake profile with my first, last name and my photo. What stupid whores then, bitches? Wow, she keeps talking about Brent Westwood's profile. Good job, Brent. You pushed her over the edge. She's having a breakdown because of you. Oh, and then I'm going to end it on a positive note. What weird weather also. Might rain today or tomorrow. And is going to be 86 degrees. Alright, that's enough of that. Yes, someone please make a song of that. That would be amazing if someone just took all of her angry tweets, turned it into some kind of a song. Do that immediately. Yeah, so I'm gonna leave this one alone where I kept running their credit card last night. Her name was Cindy. I will try to post that show today. I don't have much else going on today, so I'll probably do that. So be watching Phone Losers, if you're listening live. And I will get that posted, hopefully, before the day's over. Alright, this one, this is the lady that had me on her list. She tweeted to Toyota. She's like, I hate bad customer service. I hate when people blatantly lie to me. Toyota, you're on my list now. And, I don't know, we had a pretty amusing call, I thought. Where I kept asking her about her list. And I asked her who else was on the list. And she's like, it's not that kind of list. It's like Wendy's is on the list. Let's give her a call. I'm going to quit doing my show forever if somebody doesn't write that song about Michelle.
Hello?
Hi, is this Emily?
Yes.
Oh, could I talk to Chelsea again? We need to talk about this list.
This what?
She made a list and put us on it. I'm calling from Toyota. My name's Roy. I'm just
trying. Hi, this is Roy from Toyota. He said you made. Who is this?
My name's
Roy. This is not Toyota.
No, my name's Roy from Toyota. I'm just, one of my employees spoke to her last night about her list, and we're really worried about this list. She's made some sort of a list, and we feel kind of threatened at this point. We're just trying to clear things up here.
Not a threat. You have terrible customer service, and this is proving it. You called me at 3 in the morning, and now you're calling me during church hours when I just watched my little cousin get christened.
Oh, you're at church right now?
Yes.
Oh, okay. So this list, I mean, you're not going to hurt us, right?
No.
Okay.
The police stopped calling me.
The police have been called?
No, please stop calling
me. Oh, please. Okay. Because we were worried we were going to have to call Homeland Security or something. I mean, we felt like this could be like some sort of attack on our business, like physical.
Well, it's not. So
you don't.
It's not. So please stop calling me.
You don't have bombs or, I mean, you're not.
No.
You're not going to physically hurt anybody?
No.
Okay. Thank God. Because, I mean, the whole office here has just been really worried and nervous and stuff because of your list.
No, they haven't. This isn't even Toyota. You're full of crap. No. Please stop calling me.
We called Wendy's, too, and talked to them about the list. And they're a little worried about it. She's gone. Okay, I guess I'm done with her forever. Let's see. Did she tweet anything? Who answers their phone in church? Why would she answer her phone? Her cousin or whatever is getting christened. And she answers her phone in church. I was in a movie last night. I saw Iron Man 3 again, because it's an amazing movie. And some guy's cell phone next to me just started blaring like some rock music song, and he picked it up and said hello, and you know, he got up and walked out, but what the hell? If your phone rings, just don't answer it. Enjoy the moment. Don't answer your cell phone. Don't miss your cousin's christening just because your phone rings. Okay, this lady, Stephanie, let's see if she tweeted anything. Nope, she has not tweeted for 2 days now. Stephanie would like to write a letter to United Airlines. Who does she send it to? Complete lack of compassion by United makes me rethink my 10 years of loyalty. It's time to consider other options. Hashtag bad customer service.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, can you stop calling here?
Well, no, I'm trying to resolve a customer issue.
No, you're not. You guys are a prank website. We know what you're doing.
No, we're not.
You called us at 1:45 in the freaking morning, and that's not cool. Just please stop calling.
Why do you say we're a prank website?
Because I looked it up, dude. We have caller ID. Let me just... Please stop calling.
We're just trying to help.
Thank you.
Why don't you want to be helped?
Stopping the call. Thank you.
I'm going to call back. I'm calling back.
Why?
Because
okay,
we're trying to resolve...
Keep reporting you guys. Okay,
keep reporting it. I don't care.
Why are you being a dick?
You're being a dick.
Oh, okay.
That's weird. I mean, that's really weird. Okay, hold on. Let me call my cell phone. Oh, shit. Was he still listening? Crap. Because, I mean, it should just show Skype. All right, calling my cell phone. Maybe he just saw that it was the 661 Skype generic number, and the first thing that showed up... Oh, 650 now is what it is. Oh, wait, no. Wait. No, this is... Okay, hold on. Hold on, I gotta type something here. Okay, the number that's showing up on caller ID is the number that I gave for those rich people in Silicon Valley. I haven't turned off my caller ID yet, apparently. So, I mean, that sounds hilarious. That means those rich people have made reports on my phone number. So right now, I'm Googling my phone number, and I'm going to read whatever they've said about me. Ugh. Wow. There's nothing on top. How come I can't find anything? Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to type this phone number into the chat room. My 650 Silicon Valley phone number that ends in LOL. And if anyone in the chat room can find anything about this phone number, then tell me. Because I don't see anything. He looked it up and found out we're a prank call website. That's weird. I mean, that's more than just saying it's a prank phone call. Like, did these people in Silicon Valley figure out that I'm on Phone Losers? All right, forget it. Let me mark him off my list. He's outsmarted me. And I have one left to do, and what does it say? He says it's really terrible customer service from Virgin America. I thought they were better than this. He lives in Virginia. Her name is Victoria. Oh, wait, no, his name is Aaron. Oh, yeah, I messed this up last night, and I didn't write notes. I actually don't remember what happened on this. Oh, yeah, it was her son. So I'm calling this guy's parents. Is what I'm doing, and maybe they'll be nicer since it's a more reasonable hour now.
Hello?
Hi.
Hello?
I'm calling from Virgin America. My name's Roy. I was trying to get a hold of an Aaron. He left this number.
Sure. What's this in regard to?
Oh, he had some problems with his flight, I guess, and I was just trying to resolve his complaint.
Sure. Let me give you, I'll give you his cell number.
Okay.
This is his parents' house.
Oh, I see.
His cell number is...
Okay, so 598.
Right, 798.
Everyone in the chat room got that?
Excuse me?
Oh, I'm just like... I'm not really with Virgin America. I'm going to prank call him. All right, now I have to quickly prank call him before they call him and warn him. If he doesn't pick up, it's not going to work. Nobody in the chat room can find anything about my phone number either, so that's weird.
This is Aaron. Please leave a message. Oh,
come on, Aaron. Come on, Aaron.
This is Aaron. Please leave a message.
At the tone, please record your message. When you've finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hey, Aaron. This is Roy from Virgin America. We saw your tweets about us, and I just wanted to let you know you need to take those down. They're slanderous. And, you know, if you want to avoid a lawsuit, you will take those tweets down, because we don't appreciate you slandering us. You know that customer service was just fine, and you don't need to make up things to try and get free things or whatever. Whatever the scam is you're trying to pull. But you better take those tweets down. Thank you for flying, Virgin American. Goodbye. I guess that's it. That's the end of the show. That's the last one I had. Everyone in the chat room is trying to search for that thing for me, that phone number, and nobody can find anything. So, that's weird. I mean, where did the guy get that information? He says we're a prank call website. That's really specific to say we're a prank call website. He must have put it into a specific website that maybe hasn't hit Google yet. So maybe if you go to, I know a way I can look it up, but I'm not going to do it during the show. I'll do it after the show. I have an idea. But seriously, that's the end. It's over. I've called everything back. Nobody's retweeted anything hilarious since last night. So I guess the show's over. I don't have anything else to do. I would do a little bit of Open Book, but I found out from some people on YouTube that Open Book is broken. Let me go to OpenBook really quick and see if it's still broken. Yeah, so Facebook did some sort of an update recently with the search bar on top. If you're a Facebook user, you've noticed that the search bar on top is different. Yep, yep. OpenBook, the one at wilmoffat.github.io. What the hell country is I.O.? It's broken. I mean, it's still there, but the search stuff is not working anymore. So we need to find a new OpenBook. A new OpenBook that's not Bing.com. There is the social network search on Bing. I wonder if that still works. Let's see if that still works. What else am I going to do? I'm gonna go to Bing.com. New cell. Then I click on more. Then I click on social. And it wants me to connect to, oh, come on. Turn that off. We'd much rather hear Boots and Boys by Kesha. Cool Rob wants me to call the tire dude, but I don't want to steal that from Dirty Aaron. Maybe he's going to do that next week. I don't want to figure out Bing right now. But yeah, OpenBook's broken. Somebody find a new OpenBook. VN, you have an OpenBook script. VN just messaged me. He says, my script is broken, by the way. So I guess I'm right. It's the new search. It's broken the API or whatever. I can't believe that guy said I'm from a prank call website. That's really weird. Maybe they wrote it in their police blog. Oh, that's what I'm going to do. Hold on 1 second before I quit for the day. Oh, this is way down here. So, you know, my phone calls to that rich neighborhood, and the police actually have a blog. Oh, here's one. Suspicious circumstances. This is from the police blog in Silicon Valley. Rich neighborhood. Occurred on Fletcher Drive. Received a strange call last night. Disposition report taken. And where's the other one? There was another one. Okay, here's the two that I knew about. Occurred on Hallbrook Lane. Received phone call from a male subject asking for RP's daughter. What does RP stand for? I'm not sure. By name. States he's been receiving RP's mail, which... respondents? I don't know. Receiving the mail with detailed description of RP's house. Advises he will come by at 3 a.m. to drop off mail. Second RP describing the same caller, same MO. Disposition report taken. And then the other one, occurred on Fletcher Drive, advising unknown male called RP, complaining that RP's been driving by his house all day. I remember that one. That's the lady with the Jeep. The 2001 Jeep. RP states wife was at home all day. Caller says he lives on Marymount, first name of David. RP was able to get number from caller ID. Disposition, log note only. So that's what's going on in Silicon Valley. I'm pretty sure the cops from that town are going to show up at my door, but they're probably riding Segways, which is why it's taking so long to get up here. If any of you participated in that phone mob we did on Chelsea Peretti's podcast, it was fun. If you search for her latest podcast, or she's probably done another one by now, I haven't checked lately, but there was one call that got through where they talked about cactus, but she edited everything else out. But apparently we caused some commotion there during the show, because when I called, she picked up and was like, asked if I had any antidotes about cactus. And I don't know. I guess that's it. Everyone, go to the website later today. I'll have the show up, phonelosers.org. Join the Facebook, facebook.com/phonelosers. Bye, everyone. See you next time. Hopefully I'll do a morning show this coming week. Crystalline.
Obliviousness devoid of light till a blue ball enters his sight. It gets bigger, blue, green, and white. Tight latch spacious through the nighttime. Crashing batches, making splashes, pulling latches. Open hatches, open latches. Greens and splashes, making prints in sandy pastures. Filtered UV light, the air.
hair is sanitized. He takes a couple steps and he sends with the tides. A city past a hill looks nearly reachable. A 1,000-meter tower, crystalline color so full. Faces melted, congealed gelatin, melting drips off spooky skeletons. Light years, dark days, empires decay, time melts, spins, years drip through slow days, fumes and tubes and super glue, and mile high towers, crystal blue. In a 10-foot booth, smoking like Babe Ruth, stepping up to the plate like a baseball dude. And when that plate was stepped up to, some awesome stuff was confessed to. And in the nighttime, SWAT teamed agents busted through and handcuffed you. This one's for the kids in Lake Hills Juvenile Hall, hooching prison dynamite and burn down all the walls.
Thank you.